people. Thank you for clicking on this video. Hope you stay through its entirety. I said, you know, I'm gonna start using my platform a little bit differently and really talking about things that I've always wanted to speak about. I mean, I have the thoughts and the play through things in my head and, you know, go through this and that. But I said I want to start really talking about some stuff that I know other people think about, but just ain't going to just really maybe afraid to talk about. I don't know. But hey, let's go. This is going to touch on, yes, again, about the church. But I want to talk about barrenness and women. You ever realize the church is really fucked up? The church, and it comes from the teachings of the Bible. You ever stop and think how women feel when they can't bear children? Now here we go, we have, you know, we're in a place that this doctrine here is written by man. Here we have man trying to dictate how, and it's still happening today, how a woman's body, what it's made for, what it should do, and if it doesn't do this, you're not a woman, blah, 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 you're not worthy, blah, 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 blah. The stigma that came along with being barren back in the days still exists today. Still exists today. You know, you look, I'm sure, you know, some women experience, you know, they get married and the question keep coming. So when you having a baby? So when you having a baby? Oh, so when did it do that? My thing is, when did my body become your project? Why is it something that's not from a child, you know, from, you know, again, and it's the Bible. So they're using this man-made thing that's from ages ago and not seeing that the stuff that was written then, you can't apply it to today. You can't apply it to today. So, you know, I'm going to list some stuff down in the descriptions and you can check it out for yourself. But if you look through the Bible and it talks about women who were barren and you see how, oh, they pray to the Lord. Oh, Lord, open up my womb. Oh, Lord, you know, why are you punishing me? Why did it? Because they cannot produce a child for their husband. So you're trying to tell me the reason why, okay, so, you know, I know some, you know, whoever comes across the Bible thumpers and did it, oh, because the Lord said, you know, to be fruitful and multiply. But who said that the Lord made every woman capable of carrying a child? But there's nowhere in the Bible that talks about that. But it's a reality because guess what? There's some women that are infertile. I hope I'm using the right, yeah, that aren't fertile. Now, this really hit home to me when I had my partial hysterectomy. I went through a lot. And I realized that there's conversations that I can't have with men because, again, you have no right to tell me how to feel and what it is that I, how long it is I should, how can I say, I don't want to use mourn, but yeah, mourn something. Because you don't know and you have no right. So one of my thoughts was, oh, is this going to make me less of a woman? Imagine. That's my thought. And it comes from being ingrained in you. This is what what a woman is made for. Your body, yeah, you're an incubator. You're supposed to be pushing out them babies. So my question was, is this going to make me less of a woman? And I posed to someone and, you know, they prayed and they, you know, I don't want to say console, but reassured me that that has nothing to do with it. But I know I'm not the only person that has had this thought or somewhere along the lines. There's nowhere in the Bible that talks, that encourages, that supports or uplifts a woman that cannot have children. It comes off like it's a failure. Look at it's the same shit today. You know, this whole thing about biological clock ticking, I think it's a whole bunch of bullshit. I understand there's women that, you know, you want family, you want it, and that's great. There's nothing wrong with that. But that is an individual choice. It is not a requirement. It's not a requirement. If you don't have, you're not able to have children, it is not God's punishment. It is not God's, please, it's not God's punishment. There's a lot of kids out there that you can, that can be adopted. You know, you have, surrogate parent, you know, where the woman, someone else could carry the egg, you know, there's many ways to have a child when it doesn't grow inside of you. But it doesn't make you any less of a woman. I want you, it doesn't make you any less of a woman. If these things were embedded in us when we were younger, it wouldn't be so hard for women now when they can't have a child to with this fucking shame. Who the fuck's, God didn't make imagine if every fucking woman out here, if you look at the Jew, okay, we're not going to go there. Just keep popping out babies. Blah, 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 blah. I don't think that's God's plan for everyone to, no. And it doesn't, again, it doesn't make you less of a woman. It doesn't make you, no, because the devil, no, that is not my purpose on here purpose on this earth to just, this, I'm here just to carry babies. Trust me, it's a beautiful thing. I think motherhood is great. Having children is great. Me, myself, I love children. Did I ever want to have them in me growing and push them out? No. No. But look at the thought process that has been embedded that I would, you know, wonder, shit, my uterus coming out, is that going to make me less of a woman? We got to do better. The church, you got to do better. You know, this is why, yeah, I don't like, I don't. Because it's not real. The things that have been taught, and that are, it's not realistic. It's like, I went to college, the shit that I learned in college, I ain't using none of that shit now. Not saying it's not necessary, but guess what? Prepare me for the world that I'm going to live in. Prepare women for the reality. Guess what? You may not be able to have kids, but it's all right. God still love you. He ain't punishing you. This is not a punishment. It is not a punishment. And you are whole and loved just the way you are. Yeah, that's on my mind. Again, I'm gonna put some stuff down below. You can check it out for yourself. I'd love to hear what you got to say. Anyway, guys, on that note, I'm out.